Okay, hello and welcome to this, the 8th video in the SPT Framework series. Today we're picking up where we left off after extending our flow control component, and we're going to extend that functionality to include some inbuilt properties of the components that you would get from inheriting from the component base. So we're going to use those busy and error flags to have a method that triggers a command or triggers an operation, and the block then goes, or the class then goes through that process of completing the task we've then given to it. Let's begin. Okay, so what we're going to do first is we're going to create a method that we're going to call reset counter, and its job is very, very simple. Strange enough, it's going to reset the counter of the flow control block. Now this will be analogous to if you have a real flow counter on your IO network, resetting it back to zero. So you might imagine when we do this example, there's a real piece of IO we're resetting to create a sequence that takes more than a single PLC cycle. Okay, that's what this is about. Now you'll know from previous videos that we use a cyclic logic method to do all of the continually running processes within our component. So what does that mean? Well, it means that the other methods that we use to provide functionality, as we discussed in the last video, are actually commands. They don't do anything themselves. We don't call them continuously directly for them to do anything. Okay, we call them to trigger a behavior in our class, in our component, and when it's finished doing that, it then returns a result. So as I said, we're going to create this method, reset counter, and in it, we're going to put a very simple flag in called reset command. And if reset command isn't false, then we won't do this behavior, okay? If it is false, then we'll set it to true, which will obviously then stop this being called, and we'll then pass a true value back out of the method. So what that basically means is when you call this method and the command is accepted to reset the counter, it will tell you a true to tell you what's happened so you can move on your state machine. If it gives you a false, the command's been rejected because it's already doing it. And you'll notice then that we're adding these two flags and a thing called an error ID. So the busy, the error, and the error ID are pre-existing things within the component. Okay, so when you inherit from the component base, you gain access to these three objects. And by setting them true, we can then give you indications or give you user indications of what's actually going on. So we reset command, call the reset counter. We set our busy to true to say our class is doing something. We set our error to false to clear any previous errors, and we set our error ID to false. Okay. In our cyclic logic, that's where this behavior gets executed. You imagine, obviously, in reality, this would be inside an input or in an IO device, but we'll, for the sake of this demonstration, we'll do it inside the cyclic method here. And it's very, very simple. We're going to create some dummy variables to allow us to effectively fudge the results so that we can demonstrate both principles here of what we're trying to achieve. The first is if the reset command goes true, i.e. the command's accepted when we call the reset counter method, then this piece of code will get executed. And the first thing we're going to be doing is checking to see if there's a reset worked, i.e. if the terminal responded correctly that the reset was okay. And the second one is if that reset failed. We'll obviously be able to control these manually ourselves in this particular instance, but you can imagine linking this to IO and having it respond with status flags later on. And we'll come on to how that happens in later videos. So if the reset worked, the busy goes false, the reset command goes false, the counter gets reset to zero, obviously. And away we go. And if the reset fails, then the busy still goes false because this system has the component has stopped doing the operation. It has an answer, it's just not one we want. And we then set an error flag as true, and we set an error ID. Now we could use error IDs if they were from sort of NC classes and stuff. We could just pass through the access error IDs, for example. But if you're creating your own component, there's no reason you can't make your own error IDs as long as you log what they're doing. And what they mean, so that a user of your library could then come along and understand and interpret these error codes. Okay, so going to the main program, we will simply create a simple control variable that allows us to effectively push a reset button on the HMI to zero our counter. And when we do that, it's going to call the reset counter method. And what is then I'm going to put in is a very simple check, so that if the flow controller goes busy, which it should do, because as soon as we trigger the method, the busy flag should go true, then it will then clear that button command coming in from the main program. So hit the button to reset the counter, calls the reset counter, triggers our flow controller to do its behavior. And by watching the status flags coming back, so this busy and error flags that we have, we can then determine what the state of our component is in, okay? So we can then make decisions based on if it's busy. Obviously, this forces you into a path where you declare things as busy or not busy. So there's no done flag, okay? So you watch for busy or it's not busy. Of course, that's not to say you can't have a done flag. So if you want to take the component base from the SPT framework, inherit from that to create your own internal component base, you could then institute a done flag if that was the way you wanted to structure your code. That would be a perfectly valid thing to do. And thanks to the previous videos, you know how to now do an extends of that base function block to achieve that. Okay, so very simply then, if we line these two up against each other, we can trigger off our reset function. And you'll notice here that we've got our busy error and error ID flags already set. So if we trigger off the button to do the reset command, you'll notice here our reset command is true. Our busy is still true because it was true on initialization. And we're then going to command the reset worked. And you can see then the I counter got set to zero, the busy flag went false, and the error ID was still zero. Let's do the opposite, do a reset failed, and trigger that return. You can see now we've got an error, we've got an error ID, but the busy flag is still false. And by monitoring the flow controller.error, so the property that links to that underscore error variable, we pull this data out so the main program can see the status inside the inside the component, okay? We trigger it again, and we give it a reset worked, and you can see that's cleared everything. So calling the reset counter clears the previous error and resets it. Okay, that's been a very brief introduction to commands. Remember, when you're talking about components in the SPT framework, you have a cyclic logic method that you call is called continuously, which performs all the internal functions. So the methods you add to a component are commands. They're telling the component to do something. That should then trigger a behavior. Okay, and you can then watch when you're programming the component, you then set the busy and error flags, as I've done in this example, to allow an observer, so the main program or your state machine or some other program who's using your work, can then monitor those properties coming out to see what the busy and error states are inside the component, see what it's actually then doing. So in the next video, we're going to look at tracing. That's what we're going to use to actually push data out of our component into the TwinCat development environment to allow us to debug during development and to just track what's going on inside a component for analytics and diagnostic purposes. Look forward to seeing you then.